ready, girl.
Around three, just for fun, like right when I could start talking and singing, like so from a very young age I've been singing just for fun. And then when I was around 11 is when I started to actually perform in front of audiences. My mom got me out onto the stage and at my school. And then another thing was the Portland Trailblazers had a NBA game that I performed at. And I sang the national anthem, and that was my first time performing in front of a large audience. And after that, I did some more national anthem things, and from there, we took actually one of the national anthem videos and sent it over to Sony Music in Japan, and that's kind of how it all began. Not even professionally. That was just for fun. Like, I auditioned when I was 11 with my mom, and they called us back, and that was my first time actually performing. It was just me, my parents, my family came to support me, my friends, and it was something that was just completely, it wasn't connected to anything professionally related. It was just, I auditioned and I got in, and so, I just performed, and it was my first like actual real performance in front of a large audience. When all this happened, I was super young. I was in, like 13, 14, and when I was first working with them, it was definitely a big jump from just singing in my room or singing in front of even just audiences in the U.S. I suddenly moved, you know, to focusing on performances in Japan in front of the Japanese audience, and also performing in like live houses with a band. So everything kind of changed performance wise, and I'd never experienced performing with a band before, so I just started to learn all these new things at such a young age. So at first it was kind of I got really nervous, but excited at the same time, and it was a really great experience. The artists that influenced me the most when I was younger include Avril Lavigne, Kelly Clarkson, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, Christina Aguilera, also Utada Hikaru, or Hikaru Utada, and Yui and Ayaka. Those three, the last three that I mentioned, are Japanese artists. And so basically the powerhouse kind of vocalists were the ones that really attracted me. They're just like their singing style and their ability, no matter what genre they were, to have that kind of like power in their singing.
This is where we start our goodbyes, the oldest door.
No matter what audience type I'm preparing to sing in front of, usually if I'm going to be with a band, then if I'm going to be performing with a band, we'll rehearse together. But on my own, I'll just be, I mean, I think there's not like special, unique things that I do really. It's just kind of practice, warming up in the beginning, just like any athlete would do, or you know, it's just warming up and then go into practicing what I'm actually going to perform. And then if I'm going to be performing with a band at an event or at a show, then I'll practice with them in advance, something, things like that. Having some of my songs be the theme songs for these huge anime, it's crazy, because growing up when I was younger, I watched a lot of different anime and heard a lot about it, and it was a big part of the Japanese culture, and I knew that, but I didn't really ever imagine that, you know, after I signed a contract with Sony and that I, you know, joined the kind of like the Japanese music industry, that my songs would be featured in Japanese anime. And I think that's so special, and I'm so grateful that I had the opportunity to be a part of that, because it's very different from just having people listen to my music at a CD shop, or they're kind of expecting different things. And I think my music, by having it be the ending or the beginning of an anime, it gets very much connected to the storyline or whatever's going on in the anime. So there's more to it than just me, and I feel more connected to something else, to something bigger, which I think is very great and interesting. And I just feel like it kind of connects me more in a way, and connects my music to the Japanese culture, and through the Japanese anime. And it's kind of hard to explain, but I feel like whenever I'm watching an anime, the beginning song or the ending song, it kind of determines how I feel right as I'm going into watching the anime. So like in the very beginning, and then also at the end of the song, like right after the cliffhanger, whatever, you know, you're like, oh my gosh, I want to watch more. Like, I feel like the music at the end or at the beginning very, very much influences how you feel and those emotions that you get at the beginning or the end of an anime. So I think being a part of that magic that happens there, it's a very cool thing, and I'm grateful that I got to have my songs be kind of like those songs that segue into the beginning or the end of different anime stories. So the first time one of my songs became the ending of an anime was for Bonen no Zand, and that was my first ever experience watching like an anime and have it go right to my song. And that experience was it was a long time ago, but it was very exciting and different, and I didn't kind of know how to take it in at the beginning, because I was like, whoa, that's my song I'm singing. But it was very exciting.
We'll be right back. 'cause you promised me that you'd come back someday.
Kiki's Delivery Service and also Totoro. But yeah, I love the Ghibli movies and I've been watching them since I was a little girl. Just something, I don't know how to explain it. It's just something that I grew up watching. My mom would, that was like my first, I think that was, my, yeah, that was my first introduction to anime whatsoever. And my mom had like played a big role in, you know, that's how she actually, that was one way I actually started to learn Japanese as well. So I have like this childhood mixed like memories and connections to the Ghibli movies, and that played a big role and role in how I kind of feel about the Japanese culture now. And yeah, there's so many things that I love about the Ghibli movies, but yeah, one of my favorites is Kiki's Delivery Service. I feel like I connect most to like Kiki, especially I watched it recently. It's very different when you watch it as a little kid and then when you watch it again later on. I feel like it's kind of like watching a Disney movie again for me, just because I watched it when I was younger. And I feel like I really can connect to her because she has to go through this struggling phase where she's kind of trying to figure out who she wants to be and what she wants to do, and that kind of struggle growing up and going out to the world on your own. That's very much what I'm kind of going through right now, being a freshman in college and having to leave home and be away from family. So I feel like I can connect to her. So right now I'm working more on doing stuff in the States and more internationally, not only in Japan. Some of the things that I've been doing that I've done recently include, I did some Japanese cultural like festival events, and one of them was the Cherry Blossom Festival in San Francisco. Another was Japan Day in New York, and I performed at those and sang some of my songs. I also did recently a music video cover of this song called Just Give Me a Reason, and I did that with Kurt Schneider and Sam Shui, and that was a great experience. And so those are some of like my first kind of baby steps working into doing more stuff in internationally, globally. So those are some of the things that I've already done, and I'm working to do more things, especially this summer. It's going to be a big summer for me. This summer, I plan to work more on the music style that I want to be, that I want to show, the other side that I want to show to people internationally, globally, music-wise. When it comes to releasing songs, I plan to release my album 17 that I released in Japan. I plan to release that on iTunes to make it available for people, you know, not only in Japan. And some of the songs on there, there's 17 tracks. They have every single that I've released in Japan, because the music system's a little different, so every single that I've released from the very beginning of Vacancy, which was the Bonin Lazemt theme song. I also have other songs that people have never heard before that haven't been on singles. And then also the very last song is very special to me. It was one of the very first songs I ever wrote like the lyrics to and the track to on my own. And it's called Yours Truly. So I have a 17, all like a variety of different tracks, and I'm really excited to get that on iTunes, because a lot of people have asked like, okay, well, where can I get your music if I live in the States, or if I live here, if I don't, you know, live in Japan? So this will give me an opportunity to get my music out there to more people. So I'm really excited. When it comes to songwriting, I think it's it's very much more personal, because then when you sing those lyrics, you have more of a connection to them. When it comes to writing lyrics, things that motivate me include just, I don't know, when I'm at like a peak in emotionally, it could be something difficult that I'm going through, difficult things that my friends are going through, family members. I try to think outside of just me, and think about the people around me as well and what they're going through, because sometimes those are the times when I can, where it's the most interesting and fun for me to think, okay, if I were in their shoes, if I were experiencing this, then how would I feel? That was actually how I first wrote Vacancy. I put myself in like the shoes of someone who was experiencing, like if I had a family member that had to go serve time in the war, in Iraq, then how would I feel? So that was kind of the motivation for me to write those lyrics for Vacancy. So that's an example. I will be performing in Oakland soon, June 21st, and it's going to be at Yoshi's. It's going to be my first ever real gig in the US. Up till now, I've just been performing long shows only in Japan, but now this will give me an opportunity to have a 75-minute show, a full real show. My band from LA will be coming, and I'll be performing some of my songs that I've released in Japan, but also covers of other songs, and just trying to bring out this side of me that I haven't been able to really show in Japan, but also showing that side that I represent and that I am when I'm in Japan. So just like a variety of different things, and I'm really excited. For more information about me, you can look to my official fan page on Facebook. I also have my official website, kylee.jp. I'm also doing a Twitter, Kylee official, and also Instagram. I'm basically doing like all the different social media. So I'd like all my fans that I've been able to kind of gather from since the very beginning when I released Vacancy, all the way from the beginning, because I have a lot of fans that have told me that they've been supporting me since Vacancy and since those songs, and when can we hear more of that kind of like that American side that you first kind of showed through your songs in the beginning, but then like, where's that Kylee again, you know? I feel like I want them to know that I am working on pursuing more, you know, music. I've been doing some songs only in Japanese and not releasing much of my songs in English, and I really want to get back to the fact that I am half Japanese and I love to sing in both languages. So I don't plan on doing any more, like one more than the other anymore. I want to try exploring both, and exploring more of what I can do as a singer-songwriter and getting more involved in creating the songs and writing more of the songs. So that's what my big goal is for this summer, and just I would love it if you guys could, if my fans could just get excited, and I plan to release more new songs soon, and if I could have their continuing support, that would be great.
Todoke kono omoi o yozoru wa kimi e no kasuro hato yurasu yo kimi no koe onegai kore jo jirasanai de kakegi nante dekinakutte.